Hello, Leo, and welcome to Truth Well Told Tarot. This is Andrea, and I'm here to do your weekly tarot reading. It will be from the 3rd to the 9th of April, 2023, for the sign of Leo, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus. So I hope you're well. As always, remember this reading won't be for everyone. So let's see what we have for you. We have number 14, Drive. This is about taking the reins, forward movement, being in the driving seat. This is the Lord Ganesha deck. Helps us overcome obstacles. So let's see what we have as your angel message. I'm using the Archangel Michael deck this week. What do we have for Leo? We have number 41. Your loved ones are safe. Let go of your fear and worry for your loved ones. I am looking after them. This is a turning point. I have number 14, and then I've got number 41. Yeah, the message that I'm getting strongly with this, Leo, is there's a turning point here. 14, 41, it just feels like things turn around in a positive way. Let's see what we have with the reading. What do we have for Leo, please, for the week? Message for our lovely Leos for the week. The number 1441 might also mean something to you. We have the Lovers. Seven of Swords. Another seven, the Seven of Wands. Eight of Pentacles, the Sun, the High Priestess, we have the Five of Wands. And we have the Two of Wands. Yeah, you need illumination. The Sun in your challenge position, the Sun is a card of good news, celebration, joy, happiness, but it can be about powerful illumination where everything becomes clear to us in what we're supposed to do. It's with regard to the Seven of Swords. Seven of Swords can be a card of deception. I mean, there's levels to this as well. It can be linked with betrayal, stealing, lies, covert behavior, concealment. So whatever that scenario is, but it feels like you're wanting to find illumination in what to do next, is what I'm seeing here. The Lovers, as your overarching energy, it can be about a relationship or partnership of some kind. This can be love, romance. It can also be to do with business as well, or other areas of life, other partnerships. But it's a key decision. Where do we go from here? It can be about the relationship itself or in another area. I feel that you're waiting for some kind of illumination on what to do next, because somebody has hidden something from you, and that's come out in the open, and you're like, what do I do? What do I do? The Seven of Wands and the High Priestess, trusting your intuition. Again, the Seven of Wands can be about standing your ground, not backing down this time, standing up for what you believe is right and true. And trusting your intuition can be in terms of, sometimes this can be an energy of, I knew that was happening, I knew you did that, I knew that this was going on, you know. This can be that kind of energy. It's almost kind of like maybe some kind of inkling or suspicion or intuitive vibe that you were getting has been confirmed, and you're just like, I knew this was going on. Or I knew that you'd done this. I knew that something wasn't quite right. You know, this is that kind of energy here. And you stand your ground. With the Five of Wands, Five of Wands is a card of inner conflict, also external conflict. A conflict going round and round and round in circles with no resolution. Because you're not on the same page. You're standing up for what you believe is right and true. The other person has done something wrong. The Five of Wands can be conflict, you know, that ensues from that here, Leo. With the Eight of Pentacles, working through. The Eight of Pentacles can be about hard work, working through a situation, wanting to work hard at resolving a situation or not, or do I want to put time and energy into this anymore? You know, that's the energy here. Can I truly overcome this through working through a situation, or do I not want to? The Two of Wands is a choice. A choice can be to stay or go. Now, you know, Leo, like I said, if this can be about the relationship or partnership itself or in another life area, like I said, this can be about conflict coming out from someone's deception and you kind of saying, I knew about this. You know, I knew that you were doing this. I knew that you'd gone and done that. I suspected something here. And then you were just kind of like, can we work through this to bring change? Do I want to? There's a choice or decision to make. Which is the energy of, can we turn something around? Which is that turning point that I was getting at the beginning of the reading. In another life area here, Leo, the energy would be somebody has done something subversive, concealing, deceptive to you, and you're wanting to find illumination because you suspected it, then it was confirmed, and you're standing your ground. So this could well be, if it was a work scenario, for example, where somebody had been undermining you or backbiting or done something behind your back in some way, it might well be that you have a choice or decision to make in terms of the relationship, for example, in whether you stay at that place of work. Do I want to continue putting time and energy into this? Is it worth it? It's just conflict going round and round in circles. You know, or do I step into the unknown? Do I go and see what's out there? It might well be there's some kind of choice or decision to make, potentially pursuing new opportunities elsewhere. Because again, the Two of Wands can be about the potential of stepping into the unknown. Again, if this is about the relationship itself, the Two of Wands can be, you know, do I stay or go? How do I move forward? There's a decision to make, a choice to make. What steps do I take next? Strong indication that you have a strong intuitive energy this week and to trust that. But a feeling of you're in the driving seat here, you're taking the reins of a situation here, and deciding how you're going to move forward. Now, again, this energy of your loved ones are safe. It might well be that part of this process that you're going through is to make sure that whatever decision that you make, how that affects everybody else. And, you know, being very mindful of that as well. Two of Wands can actually be two opportunities as well. Can be, you know, your current place of work and a new one. You know, it can be stay or go in terms of relationships, and it can well be what are the next steps do I take. So however that resonates with you, the world is in your hands and you decide what happens next. Let's pull you an affirmation. First one, we have, today I choose hope. And your next one that came out, we have, nothing is impossible for the heart. Love will always find a way. Okay, Leo, I'm going to pull a final message for you. Final message for Leo. We have go outside. It's time to go outside. Tune into the powerful piece of nature wherever you are and feel at one with your habitat. Yeah, I feel that you want to turn, there's an opportunity to turn a situation around, turn something negative to positive here, Leo. But it depends on a choice and whether your current situation is for you or whether you step into the unknown. It feels like you're deciding the next steps this week. But again, this powerful energy here of your world is in your hands. That's what I have for you. I hope you enjoyed your reading. If you did, please do like, share, and subscribe. I wish you a wonderful week. I will see you next time.